Greetings students, welcome to my class. How are you my dear students? I hope you all are doing well and I hope the same for your family members. My dear students, in the previous class we started the poem Amanda, which is being written by Robin Klein. Robin Klein is the poet of this poem Amanda. So what does this poem tell us? You know, what does this poem is all about? I have given you, you know, I told you the summary of this poem yesterday. This poem is about a young girl whose name is Amanda, and it is not about this young girl only, it is not about Amanda only. This poem is basically about the psyche, means the thinking of a young child, you know, whether she's a girl or boy, it doesn't matter. In this poem she's a girl, so it is about the psyche of the young child who is being controlled, being monitored, being observed by his or her parents at each and every step, or each and every, you know, action they do. Like if they want to, you know, do something, parents will come and say, don't do this and do like this. If they want to, you know, play for long hours, or if they want to, you know, draw some painting, or if they want to, you know, like opt for some career or something, their parents say, no, this is not good for you, you should learn some manners, you should do this, you should not laugh loudly in the public, you should not make faces, you should not wear such kind of dresses, you should behave properly in front of the relatives, and all these things parents tell the young child, you know, so that they want them to become a good person, a civilized person. But all these things, all this monitoring, all this observation, all this instruction, nagging, you know, tokna, what does this do to the young child? This makes the child, you know, irritated, annoyed, frustrated, you know, and he or she starts neglecting their parents' advice or whatever their parents are saying. In this poem also we, you know, have come to know that Amanda's mother, who is always after her, who is always, you know, nagging her by saying, have you done this, don't do this, do like this. She wants her to do less mistakes, and she wants her to be perfect. And, you know, parents sometimes forget that they were also child, and in this poem mother is always after her daughter, and because of that, you know, constant nagging or constant scolding or constant observing, monitoring of her mother, the daughter, you know, she starts neglecting her mother's instructions, and she starts, you know, creating her own imagination, her world of imagination, where she is free, where she is alone, where she enjoys the freedom, where she wants, where she can do whatever she wants to do, where she can live her life on her own terms, where is no one to ask her, to scold her, to monitor her, or to nag her at each and every step of her. And every time she, you know, whenever her mother says anything to her, like mother says don't bite nail, at that, you know, moment she goes to her world of imagination, and she believes and she considered herself as a, you know, mermaid who is swimming in the vast calm green sea, peacefully, driftly, blissfully. And when her mother again, you know, scolds her and asks her that, have you done your homework, then she again, you know, finds a way to escape in her world of imagination, and she thinks this time that she is an orphan, though in reality she is not. Yet she thinks that she is an orphan, because if she were an orphan, she would enjoy the freedom. There will be, you know, she will not have mother and father, and there will be no one to ask her, to disturb her, and she will enjoy walking on the streets barefoot, and she can draw some, you know, pattern on dust or snow, soft pattern with bare feet, and no one would say anything to her. Then again, when her the mother says not to eat more chocolates or many chocolates as it causes pimples, so then also she goes into her world of imagination, and she thinks that she is Rapunzel, the fairy tale character of German fairy tale, who is being imprisoned by a witch in a tower, and she is happy there, she enjoys there, and she has golden beautiful long hair. And in that poem, when she hangs her long golden hair from the tower, a prince comes and escapes her from there, takes her from there. But Amanda thinks that she will not allow anyone to disturb her. She will enjoy that solitariness, loneliness, and she will enjoy that solitude. एकांत उसको पसंद आएगा, वहाँ पर इंजॉय करेगी, किसी को भी नहीं आने देगी, किसी भी प्रिंस को नहीं आने देगी, अपने बालों को कभी भी नहीं छूने देगी. And when she is in her world of imagination, she again her mother again brings her back in the world of reality by saying that you should look at me when I'm talking to you, stop neglecting, stop sulking, stop being so irritated all the time, otherwise people will think that I am after you. So this is the story, or this is the summary of the poem, my dear students. I thought that I should revise it again so that you can understand the poem or answer any questions. Now we will do this poem's explanation, which is very simple. I hope you all have your books with you, my dear students, and all books are open. So my dear student, this poem Amanda, which is written by Robin Klein, and this is this is about the young girl Amanda, and what the detailed explanation we will start now. Amanda, which is written by Robin Klein. Now we will start. Every child feels that she or he is controlled and instructed not to do one thing or another. You too may feel that your freedom is curtailed means restricted, bandhi gayi hai. Write down some of the things you want to do, but your parents, elders do not allow you to. Every child wants to do many things which his or her parents won't allow him or her to do. It's obvious, right? To read the poem aloud, form pairs, each reading alternative stanzas, you are in for a surprise. Means when you read this poem, you can attach yourselves with this poem, you can put yourself in Amanda's shoes. Amanda ki jagah par apne aap ko rakh kar dekh sakte ho. Maybe instructions or do's and don'ts list would be different, but the condition is same. This is the poem is all about. So the poem starts like this. Don't bite your nails, Amanda. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Stop that slouching and sit up straight, Amanda. So in this first stanza one, the mother is talking to the girl Amanda. She is again nagging her by saying, usko tok rahi hai, rok rahi hai, that don't bite your nails, apne nails mat chabao. People have this tendency to chew their nails, and when you are big enough, people don't say to anything. But if you are small like Amanda, young, and you have parents, her mother says to her that don't bite your nails, apne nakhun mat kutro ya chabao. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Hunch your shoulders means ab apne shoulders, when you raise your shoulders like this and you bend your body like this, to ye like it's like you might enjoy sitting in this position or posture, but your parents think, what is this, ye kubar sa mat banao, aise jhuk ke mat baitho. Stop that slouching and sit up straight. Slouching means standing, moving, or sitting in a lazy way. Up, maybe you are sitting in a lazy way. Parent says, why are you sitting like this? Why can't you sit straight? So Amanda's mother also says, don't bite your nails, don't make your body posture wrong and sit straight while you are sitting. Don't slouch, मतलब झुको मत, आराम से lazy way में मत बैठो. So in this first stanza, mother is saying this. And when mother is saying this, as I told you, Amanda is a defiance girl, means who is started neglecting her mother's saying. Whatever her mother says, she just doesn't bother. Yes, my dear student. So she goes into her world of imagination, and then in this parenthesis, means it is in bracket, what she what is the her world of imagination. First, there is a languid emerald sea, languid a bright green precious, languid is relaxed, calm. Green emerald sea, means emerald means a stone, moti hare color ka, aur wo bol rahe hain, she is saying Amanda is in her world of imagination when her mother is stopping her by chewing her nails and saying her to sit straight, don't slouch your body and all. So she, at that point of time, she is thinking about that she is there, is that there is a language, means relaxed green sea, wide, relaxed, calm green sea, where the sole inhabitant is me, where she is thinking that only one in that wild, calm, vast green sea, she is the only living person there, inhabitant, matlab jo aapko wahan pe milega, to wo hi hai bas, only ki main hi hoon. A mermaid drifting blissfully. So she is considering herself as a mermaid there in that, calm green sea, and she is the only one in that green sea. She thinks that she is a mermaid who is drifting blissfully. Drifting meaning is given, moving slowly, and blissfully means moving slowly. And mermaid is a mythical, creature, sea creature, jalpari jisko hum bolte hain. So वो एक जल परी है जो उस अतः ग्रीन काम सागर में सिर्फ वो ही है और वो तैर रही है ब्लिसफुली, बिल्कुल ही काम आनंदमय तरीके से और तैर रही है. When she is in her world of imagination, her mother brings her back into the world of reality by saying, did you finish your homework Amanda? Did you tidy your room Amanda? I thought I told you to clean your shoes, Amanda. Now mother is again nagging her by saying that, asking her that, did you finish your homework, Amanda? Kya tumne apna homework pura kiya tha? Did you tidy your room, Amanda? Kya tumne apna room clean kiya tha ya nahi kiya tha? I thought I told you to clean your shoes. Aur mujhe lagta ki maine tumhe kaha tha that you should clean your shoes. Tumhe apne joote bhi saaf karne chahiye. So mother is saying all this thing to Amanda, and when mother is giving her instructions again by asking her many questions, did you do your homework, clean your room, clean your shoes or not, she again finds or escapes into her world of imagination. And what does she thinks? And again you can see that this is in bracket or parenthesis. The parenthesis, the bracket mein hai, my dear students, these are the Amanda's thinking, imagination. She is in her world of imagination. She thinks that I am an orphan. Orphan, whose child whose parents are no more. Roaming the street. She is an orphan this time, she thinks, and she is roaming in the street. Gali mein ghum rahi hai. I patch on soft dust, aur jo dhool mitti hai wahan par, with my hushed bare feet. Very quiet and still. And she is walking, she is an orphan, she is walking in the street. Roaming means walking or ghoom rahi hai idhar, and she is making some pattern on the dust with her bare feet, hushed bare feet, matlab quietly, slowly she is making some pattern with her feet, bare feet, nange pair hai wo, aur usi nange pairon se bahut hi slowly, quietly she is making some pattern, kuch design bana rahi hai ret mein, jaise hum sometime we also do when we walk bare feet in the sand or near the seashore or river shore or dust, we make some pattern, any pattern, right? So she was also doing this thing. The silence is golden. Silence maun hai jo, chuppi, shanti is golden, sunehra hai. The freedom is sweet, aur jo स्वतंत्रता है, द लिबर्टी, यू नो शी इज़ एन ऑर्फन, नो वन टू आस्क एनीथिंग, पेरेंट्स आर नो मोर, एंड शी इज़ वॉकिंग ऑन द स्ट्रीट, रोमिंग इन द स्ट्रीट एंड मेकिंग सम सॉफ्ट पैटर्न फ्रॉम हर बेयर फीट, नो वन टू आस्क, देर इज़ अ यू नो देर इज़ पीस, देर इज़ साइलेंस, एंड दैट शी फाइंड्स दैट पीस एंड साइलेंस गोल्डन, एंड फ्रीडम इज स्वीट, उसके लिए जो स्वतंत्रता है वो बहुत ही स्वीट है, बहुत ही मधुर है. अगेन हर मदर ब्रिंग्स हर बैक फ्रॉम यू नो ब्रिंग्स हर बैक फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड ऑफ इमेजिनेशन टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ रियलिटी. हर मदर सेज दिस टाइम, डोंट ईट दैट चॉकलेट अमेंडा, रिमेंबर योर एक्ने अमेंडा, विल यू प्लीज लुक एट मी व्हेन आई एम स्पीकिंग टू यू अमेंडा. सो दिस टाइम मदर सेज बिकॉज शी इज हैविंग एक्ने मीन्स पिम्पल्स मुहासे हो जाते हैं जो, सो शी सेंग बिकॉज यू ईट चॉकलेट मैन टू मैनी चॉकलेट्स दैट्स वाई दीज एंकल्स और सॉरी एक्ने और पिम्पल्स आर हैपनिंग. सो मदर से डोंट ईट दैट चॉकलेट, उस चॉकलेट को मत खाओ. द चॉकलेट विच शी वॉज अबाउट टू ईट शी से डोंट ईट दैट चॉकलेट अमेंडा, रिमेंबर योर एक्ने अमेंडा, विल यू प्लीज लुक एट मी व्हेन आई एम स्पीकिंग टू यू Amanda, or she is also saying, because Amanda, when mother is saying anything to her, she always, you know, not looking to her mother, and she is saying, when I speak to you, look at me. She doesn't look at her, she looks somewhere else, you know, like parents is saying, and my parents are saying something to me, I am looking here and there. So she does the same thing. Now, next paragraph. And then again she goes into her world of imagination. This time she thinks, I am Rapunzel, I have not a care, life in a tower is tranquil and rare. Tranquil means free from calm, free from disturbance, calm, no, bahut hi shant hai. I'll certainly never let down my bright hair. This time she thinks that she is Rapunzel, the fairy tale character. It is a German fairy tale, and in this fairy tale this young girl is being imprisoned by the witch, and she's imprisoned in a tower, and she's alone there. She has very beautiful and very long hair, and in that fairy tale a princess come with by hanging from her hair, and he takes her with him, and she says she becomes free. But Rapunzel, Amanda says that I will certainly never let down my bright hair. मैं कभी भी अपने bright hair को नीचे नहीं लटकाऊंगी, golden hairs को, सुनहरे चमकीले बालों को, ताकि कोई prince आए और मुझे यहाँ से ले जाए. Because I like this freedom, I like this loneliness, I like this solitariness, and I want to live here alone, and I will never let my hair hang down so that anybody can come, any prince can come and take me away from here. No, I want to live here because I'm free here. Again her mother says and brings her back from into the world of reality, from the world of imagination. She says, stop that sulking at once. Sulking means when you are irritated by something, chidchide ho jana, gusse mein rehna, udaas rehna, mayus rehna, nirash rehna, chidchida rehna. So she's saying, stop that sulking at once. Abhi chidchidana band kar do, irritate hona band kar do, Amanda. You are always so moody, Amanda. Aur tum hamesha apne mood mein hi rehti ho. Anyone would think that I nagged at you, Amanda. And she wants her daughter to stop sulking, stop being irritated, because anyone would think that, and stop being moody, because anybody would think, if anybody would see, they will think. Mother is conscious about her image, that if anybody would see, they would think about mother, that what kind of a mother who is always after her, who is always nagging her daughter or her child. That's why she says that stop sulking, udaas hona band karo, chidchida hona band karo, aur moody hona band karo, aise chidchidi मत रहा करो, नहीं तो लोग देखेंगे और सोचेंगे मैं हमेशा तुम्हारे पीछे पड़ी रहती हूँ. तो दिस वॉज द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोम Amanda, माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप द पोम एक्सप्लेनेशन इज क्लियर टू यू. वेल आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू अबाउट द राइम स्कीम. द राइम स्कीम इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग ऑफ दिस पोम माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स. इफ यू सी द फर्स्ट स्टेंजा, डोंट बाइट योर नेल्स Amanda, राइम स्कीम द फर्स्ट Amanda. A sound. Then don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Again, same sound. Then stop that slouching and sit up straight. Straight. So the rhyme scheme of the first stanza would be A A B, and then last line Amanda A. So A A B A. Second stanza, there is a languid emerald sea where the sole inhabitant is me, a mermaid drifting blissfully. So A A and you will write C there. Okay, A A B. First stanza rhyme is A A B A. Second stanza rhyme would be A A C me A A, and then you will write B there. Okay, my dear student. C there, sorry, because it is the different word. So A A C. Now, did you finish your homework, Amanda? Did you tidy your room, Amanda? I thought I told you to clean your shoes. Next line, fourth line, third stanza, fourth line, Amanda. So the rhyme would be A A D A. Why D is coming in first stanza? A A B. Third line, the rhyme scheme would be B, and then again Amanda A. The C me A A, and then blissfully C me and blissfully. Second stanza rhyme would be A A A, because C me blissfully me E sound is coming in all. So second stanza would be A A A. Third would be, did you finish your homework, Amanda? A. Did you tidy your room, Amanda? A. I thought I told you to clean your shoes. D. B. And then B. And then D. Amanda. Then I am an orphan roaming the street. Street, different word. I patten soft dust with my hushed bare feet. Same word. The silence is golden. The freedom is sweet. So sweet, bare feet, sweet. Same sound will go E E E. Don't eat the chocolate, Amanda. Amanda A. Remember your acne, Amanda A. Will you please look at me when I'm looking, speaking to you? Different word F, then Amanda A. So like this you will make the rhyme scheme. Now let's discuss the question answer of this chapter, this poem, my dear students. How old do you think Amanda is? Amanda is a school going girl, because we come to know, how do you know this? We come to know by her mother's questions. When she asked that, did you finish your homework? Did you clean your room? You know, like homework when you get when you go to school. Who do you think is speaking to her? Obviously her mother is speaking to her. Why are the stanzas 2, 4 and 6 given in parentheses? 2, 4 and 6 stanzas are the imaginations of Amanda. So she is thinking those paragraphs while her mother is speaking stanzas, while her mother is speaking to her. And that's why those stanzas tells us that these are in bracket, because parenthesis, because they are the imagination of Amanda. Who is the speaker in stanzas 2, 4 and 6? 2, 4 and 6 means Amanda's imagination. So Amanda is the speaker. Do you think this speaker is listening to the speaker in stanzas 1, 3, 5 and 7? No, obviously not. Amanda, whenever her mother is talking to her in the first, third, fifth and seventh stanza, Amanda is busy in her world of imagination. So she is not listening to her mother. What could Amanda do if she were a mermaid? Very easy question, my dear students, to answer. If Amanda were a mermaid, she would swim blissfully, drifting blissfully in the wide, calm, wide green sea. So now next question, my dear students, is Amanda an orphan? No, she is not an orphan. She has parents. And why does she say so? The reason is obvious. Her mother is always after her. Her mother doesn't allow her to live her life on her own, by her own choice. And that's why she wants freedom. She wants the loneliness. She wants to do the things on her own way. That's why she says that I'm an orphan and I'm roaming in the street, making some pattern with my making some soft pattern on dust with my bare feet, and nobody would say anything to me. This, she wants freedom. That's why she says that she is an orphan. Do you know the story of Rapunzel? Why does she want to be Rapunzel? She means Amanda. Why does Amanda? Rapunzel is the story, very famous story, German fairy tale. You may know or maybe you don't know. You may know or you may not, but it is a very famous story. She, I gave you a hint that she. So why does Amanda wants to be Rapunzel? She wants to be Rapunzel because Rapunzel was imprisoned by a witch in the tower where she was all alone. So Amanda also wants this type of life where she was all alone, where her mother is not after her, and where she can live her life on her own terms, and she would not allow anyone to come in the tower to disturb her privacy, disturb her freedom. And now, my dear student, next question. What does the girl yearn for? The girl yearn for means she, what does she wants? Kya chahti hai wo? She wants freedom. What does the poem tell you about Amanda? Amanda is a young girl who is very imaginative. You know, she is not irritated. She is, yeah, she does some things which her mother thinks that she does should not do in that way. But she is a very imaginative girl because she thinks creative girl, and she has innovative power, and she has a huge imagination power. And we come to know by the, because in the first, when mother says don't bite your nail, she thinks, she imagines that she is a mermaid and she is swimming in a long calm green sea. Then again she imagines that she is an orphan. Then she imagines she is a Rapunzel. So her world of imagination is very vast, wide, and she is very good imaginative girl. Read the last stanza. Do you think Amanda is sulking and moody? No, I don't think that Amanda is sulking and moody. She is doing that thing because she is irritated by her mother's mother's constant nagging, constant observing on her, constant scolding on her, don't do this and long list. That's why she is not looking at her mother, and she is not sulking, she is not moody, she is very creative and imaginative girl. So this was these were the questions, my dear student, which we have discussed. This poem is completed, and in today's class, that is it. We will meet tomorrow. Till then, take care of yourselves and your family members too. Thank you and have a nice day.